Both deliverables, the museum artifacts, and quilt panels went through multiple levels of critique. Working with student-selected topics from the first essay in the 1619 projects, students created two- and three-dimensional mock-ups of their proposed museum artifact. After 1 week of prototyping, students participated in a round-robin critique session. Each developer had to present to 7 different students, explaining why they chose the artifact to represent their historical event, and identifying the strengths and weaknesses of their artifact. Students received feedback from each one of the people who participated in their individual session.
Trying to get rid of teachers, trying to get rid of buildings, even though these buildings and these teachers that had this information, students weren't really being given the best of the best.
Based on feedback received from this session and others, this artifact was created to represent Senator Vardaman's white supremacist views in the 19-teens. Following a group brainstorming session based on the topics in the 1619 series, students viewed an exemplar quilt panel. Students with this information in mind began to examine subtopics in detail so that they could create paper mock-ups of what they wanted to represent on their quilts. These paper mock-ups were critiqued by 2 other groups. They were then transferred to the quilts. This process took about a week, where students were provided feedback as they were assembling their quilts. Running in tandem with the completion of the quilt panels, students were also finalizing their artifact paragraphs for the museum exhibit and the essay that went along with each section of the quilt panels.